this country. My daughter was first invited, so when she came, she led to the apostle, and the apostle now asked her to invite the family. So I came that day. So after the discussion, the apostle went back to his office. Later he came back again. He said that the Lord ministered to him and he should lay hands on the people that day. So I was among the people that he laid hands on, not knowing that time. God was trying to lead my one and part of certain things for me. I never knew what the devil actually planned for me. So on that day, after the service, I went back home. So after eating my night food, I was just passing waiting for the back to bring light. So we were there, we just slept for me. But I later got from around that time to 12 at night. So I went to the bedroom to just ease myself to urinate. So as I was urinating, I started feeling this. So I said, okay, let me just finish urinating. I'm just moving myself back to the bedroom and then just sleep and rest. That was all I could remember that happened. I never knew that. I just fell down to the exit. It was a double flat. My neighbor is living on the one bedroom. I was sleeping and I'm occupying the three bedroom. So I never knew that when I fell down, my neighbor wife also had it from their own corner there. So they rushed out, but due to my door was closed, my wife was just shouting on top of her. Because all this I'm saying was what they told me after the Lord invited me. So my daughter, all of them, they said they were crying and they were saying, "Daddy, please don't leave us, don't leave us. Daddy, you can only go at this point in time." So my first son, my son just came and said, "Mommy, that you are not supposed to allow that entity to be together. You have to put time to see how you can open it." So my second daughter rushed inside and brought an anointing oil. So with the applied on me. And later on, I just see myself, I woke up and I saw my wife holding me. I said, "Oh, what am I doing here?" And they said, "You don't know what happened. That even your white eye, your black eye has gone inside the white one." And I woke up to still see my teeth together. So I knew that God has really done something, because assuming I didn't come as the pastor invited me, I never knew what would have happened. And even that day, the pastor just praised the Lord. The pastor prophesied to me, he said that somebody is going to die within that very week. So on Wednesday, I was in a dream. I was going somewhere. So somebody came and he told me, "Where do you think you are going?" I said, "I want to go somewhere." He said, "No, someone like you is not permitted to know this road."
Yes, sir.
I was just looking at him. I couldn't utter a word, and the man was that serious. He was telling me, ordering me to go back to where I was coming from. I was just looking at him. At a point, I don't have a voice within me telling me I should just look at the man very well, that he looks like someone who is drunk. And when I looked at the direction he was asking me to go back to, I saw a ditch there, just like a trench. So the spirit ministered to me, I should not push the man there. So I just pushed, just little, that the man fell into the ditch. And as he was inside the ditch, he looked up and he saw me up there. So he couldn't say anything, I just woke up. So after 2 days, I called my elder sister to me, and he told me that one of the strong men, because the man had been so strong that he doesn't have him anymore. So this time, maybe somebody will tell him, he said that anytime he bent down, he will feel the crown. That means anytime he bent down to do his divination or suspense something, somebody must surely die. So by the grace of God, he's gone and gone.
Because I see patients live 4 hours and have oxygen of 8,000, and I'm going to pay for air. How much will you have paid for 24 hours? The Belgians, thank you. I am able to thank God because there's a first night in this church was my spirit. Every spirit is for someone who you get connected to the world. And after you hear your word, sit on the word and speak on the word. I want to thank God because that was the first night. I don't like my prayer request. I stopped for a while, but I came and said, right, I wrote some. And one of it was that, Father, I want my family member, especially my husband, to be closer to you. I want you to disconnect it from your friendly friends and connect it to destiny helpers. And mention something and God did it. Somebody tried with something and be successful, and the person was like, this is not what people tell me about you. And that was the destiny helper God connected me to. And immediately he said, I'm sending your name for appointment. And when he sent the name, he came and told me, he gave me an appointment. I said, I don't know. Though I also, my prayer point was that, Father, anything that is about to happen, I want to be a step forward in the spiritual life. Let me know. I just told him, and people have started calling me. They might be in contest, but God will still put you back to that position. And God did it, and he was given an appointment later. I was waiting for the appointment later before I come back to say this testimony. He was given an appointment letter last week. And not just that, God connected me to contracts that, but now we are for millions to receive those contracts. To give God all the glory for his glory. You have come exceedingly and